Two. Oh, it's nice. So one, one. Now we're on everyone's favorite 2CP maps.
Ready for battle.
Stop it.
Well.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Attack. This spot, I could. This spot's interesting. I can see why they hold here, because they have like before, like either they had like Arisa like playing like the corner here, and then Sig on like the corner, but then they could just get like hard rush. And since Shock has been playing rush a lot, I guess playing like this little like bottom left spot stops them from going high ground. So then they want to try and keep like this whole like left side control, and while Echo plays the right. So, I think that's probably why they're playing at the left side, like both together instead of playing separately. Is it one? No, it's 1-1. 1-1 right now. No shield service means stays up longer? Yeah. And since Shock want to get into the left side, like, since they're already both here, it helps them at least try and, like, shut down the left side. The left side definitely gives way more value than the right side. So then being able to be all here and like contest this spot, this high ground is really good for the Outlaws. The high ground in the back, not necessarily depending on the comp. If they're running like the Winston comp, then you want to do as much damage before they walk in, right? So you want them to, you want to force them to use their jump to engage and not take as much space as possible. So if you're just playing back here, then they get into like the left for free, they get into the right for free, they can rotate around. So against like, if it was like Arisa versus Arisa, then like, you know, playing distance and stuff like that is fine. But if you're running into like the Winston and stuff comps, then playing a little bit closer and denying them like the easy rotates is a lot better, because then your healers can play farther back and they can't just like, if they jump past, right, then you shield off, pressure their healers can't get value, and then you just destroy the tank that just jumped. So it's to deny a bunch of like space. But if it's like Arisa versus Arisa, then yeah, you play like a little bit farther back and it works. Let's see how they're close to pretty much all their ulties. That's just a normal engage by the Shock to get Choi charge. You just jump up top for bubble and then drop off. See Jungle trying to get back to his team. It's all on the top. Oh, Smurf missed his jump. Oh damn, but he got he got fucking insta deleted. But yeah, they're holding like close, and it forces like Smurf to have to try and like, there's no way for him to get to like the backline without jumping past like his whole team. Has an HP gone instant, yeah. See, like in like these fights like this is like it works out for the Outlaws a lot better. It kind of just denies like the Shock being able to do anything that they want to do. Like the Shock definitely want to be able to get in spot, like get into a spot to where Smurf can dive like Crimzo or Happy, and then Glister's there to engage, right? But by them playing like the tanks close like this, like Smurf, there's no way he can dive. If he goes too deep, then is, you know, he just gets completely rolled. I like that Bongo by Jungu there. Double shield versus double bubble, yeah. I think Shock would have had a better value if Ons was on Echo and they were on, like, the same thing with Outlaws. Like, double bubble is better if they were, like, if the Outlaws comp was mirrored, but instead of, like, BAP, like, Lucio was, like, on a, like, Mercy with, like, Echo. Because, like, Hanzo doesn't really do much value for dive. I think Echo just does so much more work. Echo's not an Ons's, like, wool house, unfortunately. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Ons is like a... whoever, like, hit scan, like, player. I'm saying, like, it definitely, like... it would have been better for the comp if, like, they had that. I think they weren't getting much value. Because, like, Ons was not the best for, like, a hard, like, dive DPS, which they were going for with the double bubble. So it's kind of like half and half on, like, at least their DPS comp needed to, like, full commit something. Because there's no way they break two shields just with a Hanzo. So usually they're just shooting shields the whole time unless he gets a lucky pick. But, okay, we didn't look at the last fight because we were talking, so... let's see how they re-engage. So, Nage's taken out. This is good. So, like, they wait, they give two ticks, and then they look to engage all together. Going with the dupe. Slam. Oh, missed the little grapple there, but. Got focused the same target there. So, waiting to re engage. Work down in their favor because then they just. Dive a target with the copy, and that's kind of just easy clap at that point. That was a good re-engage by Outlaws. Why are focus to Zarya? Because if the Zarya is high charge, and she has no bubble, you definitely want to get her out of the fight because she's the one that's going to turn the fight. If she's, like, stuck in a corner or something like that, you just, like, Zarya no bubble, you kill her. That's, like, one of, like, the high priority targets if you don't have, like, your engage. Like, he didn't have like the mash or whatever or any grapple, so it's like you're gonna just go for the person you can get. Zarya 100 charge is more dementia full charge. I'm actually not sure about the full damages like that, but yeah, that's why even in like top 500 stuff where you see like Zarya with no bubble, you want to kill her 100%. She's the one that's gonna carry the fight. Like, the supports are good, like, in the beginning of the fight, or if they're out of position, but if it's mid-fight and you see Zarya out of position with no bubble, that's, like, your go-to target to get the fuck out of there. Yo-ho, the Lord Enzo? Can I get a shout in the chat for Lord Enzo? Oh, you guys, I gotta follow him. But I got a bronze, yeah, I got you, bro. This is how you get out of bronze. You just copy these strats. So, Shocker on their, like, dive comp, like-ish, and then Outlaws are pretty much, like, full counter dive. So, Outlaws pretty much is, like, they can either go left side or right side, because they're just gonna play to just get on top of, honestly, whoever they want. Like, if they can get on top of the Honor Forcer back, then that kind of works out in their favor. And if Shock wanted, like, hard dive, then... they kind of just get rolled by the Torb. But getting like top left high grounds works for the Orisa comps. So you can just take point for free, like go like left to point. So like they are taking the left side approach. I would say high ground's a little bit better to take to force them off the high grounds. But they end up getting the pick on a Smurf. And then choice. Wait, how did Smurf die? Because definitely, like, if you're rotating here, I think rotating high ground and forcing them off, then you're at no risk of, like, getting, like, anti it or anything like that. I think they were like 50-50 on like what they wanted to do, and they just said to go point. But going high ground, I think, is definitely the better option if you have the chance, just to make sure you're not going to get dropped on. But I don't know what, how Smurf died here. So we jumped in. Oh yeah, he just jumped in and got like insta deleted. Yeah, there's, I don't know, jumping into like a Torb Kree with a Bap Rig is, I think this was like literally a really bad comp for the Shock. And now I just played like countered it really well and use it to their advantage. Why are they swap off super? Because you can see that their Shock were looking to do dive comp, and Smurf does have a better like dive hero pool with Winston. Like super is definitely the better Rein, and then super is the better, or Smurf is the better like for like dive DPS. So they wanted to try and run, or like the dive tanks, I mean. So they want to try and run the dive tanks, but with Ons, I don't know, I feel like they probably definitely need an Echo player to do like the Echo engages. They didn't have that, and then Outlaw just had a better comp, and then they play to their strengths. As you can see there, they couldn't really do much. You're gonna dive in. Yeah, you have a D.Va and a Tracer, but then, you know, yeah.